The Phlebotomy Textbook, Chapter 5, Anatomy and Physiology. Please see the PowerPoint in eLearn for learning outcomes and key terms. Key term definitions and facts can be studied using StudyMate. The term anatomy means the study of the structures of the body, and the term physiology is the study of the functioning of the body. Think of it as anatomy being what things look like and where they are, and physiology being how they work. The body has organizational levels, starting from the smallest to the largest, our cells, tissues, organs, body systems, and organism. Each level includes the previous level within it. Cells are part of tissues. Tissues are part of organs. Organs are part of body systems, and body systems are part of an organism. The smallest functioning unit of the body is the cell. More than 30 trillion cells make up the basic building blocks for the various structures that make up the human body. The size, shape, and composition of the cell determines its function. There are several different types of cells, each with a specialized function and the ability to carry out specialized chemical reactions to communicate with other cells throughout the body. A group of specialized cells with a similar structure and function form the different types of body tissues and together perform specialized functions. There are four tissue types. Epithelial tissue is made of flat cells in a sheet-like arrangement that cover and line body surfaces. Your skin is epithelial tissue. Connective tissue is blood, bone, and cartilage, and adipose cells that connect tissues and organs and provide a support network for organs. Blood is a connective tissue that you will be collecting routinely as a phlebotomist. Muscle tissue is long, slender cells that provide the contractile tissue for movement of the body. We use our muscle to perform our functions as a phlebotomist, and the patient uses their muscles to put their arm into the correct position for collection. Nerve tissues are cells capable of transmitting electrical impulses to regulate body functions. We want to avoid the needle coming in contact with nerves when we collect blood. Organs are body structures formed by the combination of two or more different types of tissue. For example, the heart is made of all four types of tissue. Each organ is a specialized component of the body and accomplishes a specific function. The skin is the largest organ. The brain is the command center of the central nervous system. And the kidneys filter your blood to maintain body pH and level of hydration. There are a lot more organs, but these are some examples. Body systems are groups of organs functioning together for a common purpose, make up body systems. The major body systems are the integumentary, skeletal, muscular, nervous, respiratory, digestive, urinary, endocrine, reproductive, circulatory, and lymphatic. Several body systems make up a complete living entity called an organism. The human body has attained the highest level of organization. The ability of these body systems to work together to sustain life and keep the body functioning normally in spite of constantly changing conditions internally and in the external environment is an essential function referred to as homeostasis. Here are some body organizational levels. So the system is integumentary. Its function is to protect against harmful pathogens and chemicals and regulate temperature. The organs in the integumentary system are skin, hair, nails, and glands. The skeletal system supports and protects internal organs, stores minerals, and is location of blood cell formation. These are bones, ligaments, joints, and cartilage. The muscular system controls skeletal movement and heat production, and the organs are muscles and tendons. The nervous system recognizes and interprets sensory stimuli and regulates responses to the stimuli by coordinating other body systems. The organs include brain, spinal cord, and nerves. The respiratory system functions in the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide between the air and circulating blood. The organs include the nose, the pharynx, the larynx, the trachea, bronchi, and the lungs. The digestive system functions to break down food to usable molecules to be absorbed by the body and eliminate waste products. The organs include the mouth, the pharynx, the esophagus, stomach, small intestines, large intestines, and rectum. The urinary system removes waste products and regulates balance of water and salt. The kidneys, ureters, urinary bladder, and the urethra are its organs. The endocrine system produces and regulates hormones. The organs include the thyroid gland, parathyroid gland, adrenal gland, pancreas, pituitary gland, ovaries, testes, thymus, and pineal gland. The reproductive system regulates sexual reproduction and development of male and female sexual characteristics. The organs include, in females, ovaries and fallopian tubes, uterus, vagina, and breasts. In males, the testes, epididymis, vas deferens, seminal vesicles, prostate gland, bulbial urethral gland, and penis are the organs. The lymphatic system functions to regulate excessive fluid, tissue fluid to the bloodstream and defends against disease. The organs include lymph vessels, ducts, lymph nodes, spleen, tonsils, and thymus. The circulatory system functions to transport oxygen, nutrients, and waste products. The organs include the heart, arteries, veins, and capillaries. Homeostasis means keeping the body functioning normally to sustain life, a steady state during constantly changing conditions. These terms will be in the study mate definitions section. To correctly identify anatomical parts of the body, you must understand these terms. When we describe the parts of the body in healthcare, we describe them using directional terms and with the patient in the anatomical position. The anatomical position is the patient standing erect, facing forward, with the arms by the sides and the palms facing forwards. Notice that the lower part of your arm will not have the parts in the same place as compared to the body if the palms are facing backwards. In an anatomy course, you must pay close attention to if you are looking at the left arm or the right arm when determining what veins or arteries you are labeling. The same issue with the bones in the lower portion of the arm or the legs. Directional terms used in anatomy include anterior, meaning the front of or before. Example, the chest is anterior to the spine. The term posterior, towards the back. The spine is posterior to the chest. Superior, meaning above in an upward direction. The head is superior to the chest. Inferior means below in a downward direction. The chest is inferior to the head. Proximal means point of attachment near the body center. The knee is proximal to the foot. Distal, point of attachment is further from the center. The foot is distal to the knee. Lateral means to the side. The shoulder is lateral to the chest. Medial, nearest the midline. The chest is medial to the shoulder. Ventral, the front. The chest is on the ventral side of the body. Therefore, ventral and anterior mean the same thing. Dorsal, the back. The spine is dorsal side of the body. This means that dorsal means the same as posterior. Superficial means towards the surface. The skin is a superficial organ. Deep, towards the interior. The femoral artery is deep in the body. Internal, within or interior to. The brain is internal to the skull. External, outside, exterior to the ribs are external to the lungs. So internal and deep would have the same meaning, and superficial and external would have the same directional meaning. Parietal is pertaining to the wall of a cavity. The parietal pleura lines the chest cavity. Visceral is pertaining to the organs within a cavity. The visceral pleura covers the lungs.